Tamara here. Nice of you to join me.
We are on video
8
of our Chest of Memories series of videos, and we will be doing page 4 today. So page 4 has got the pocket inside, so that's going to be quite exciting. If you've got to this video by accident and you want to watch the whole series from the beginning, then head on to that link up there, and that's the link to the playlist for all of this series of videos. So you can watch and hopefully craft along with me. So getting into our book. Now, as I say, we're on page 4. And page 4 is going to look a little bit like this page here. So this page here has got, it's a belly band flap that flaps up, and it's got a little flap here. And then inside we've got then a little booklet that fits underneath that flap like so. But this page is also going to have a bigger flap, which is this here, which flaps open to then you can see the, you've obviously got the pocket underneath. Okay, I'm going to cut in cream, but when I come to make it all up, I will use my black cardstock because it goes with my album. So, the measurements are, now we'll put the measurements at the beginning of the video as well, so that you can pause that and then you can take down the notes of what measurements are. So for your flap, we need to cut your cardstock at 6 5/8 by 5 5/8. So the flap on the flap, you need to cut these measurements, and the measurements are 10 3/4 by 4. Then you need to score at 5 3/8. Fold them over, increase that score. And then that is going to fit on top of our flap. Now, the little flap that then goes over the top, you can use one of the offcuts from the cardstock that you've cut for the little flap. And the measurement is 2 5/8 by 3 1/2. So that then goes over there. Now for the book, the little booklet that goes inside, we need to cut our cardstock at 10 4/4. So I think, apart from our booklet in between, behind, that's all the cutting at the moment. So, but we'll do the tags and that last. So starting with your flap, so the biggest flap that you have got, let me just come into the picture here. Using the biggest flap that you've got, you need your measurement that is your 6 1/2. Your 6 5/8, that needs to be along the top of your board. So you then need to score at 1/2 inch and then at 5/8. Okay, so let's just fold them over. So that's the flap. Okay, then we've got our little tiny flap. And then that needs to go with your 2 5/8 measurement along the top. And then we're going to score it at 1/2 inch. This is just giving you a glue tab so we can fold them under. And then lastly, for all our scores at the moment, we've got our booklet and we need to score. So the longer measurement is along the top at 10 and we're going to score at 5. Okay, fold them over. Make sure you've got a nice even. So at the moment that then is all our scoring that we need to do for this the moment. So if you have rounded your edges, I suggest that you do that now before we stick them into our book. Now I use the 1/4 inch rounding side on my project. Right, before we start to glue any of our pieces on, we need to cut our pattern paper for the base page. So, because we've got a pocket here, we don't need that full sheet. So that's saving on a little bit of your cardstock. I'm sorry, your pattern paper. So we need to cut this top bit at 4 5/5/8. Okay, you need to just round one edge of these, so just this top edge here on the outside. Make sure you get it in the right place and ink your edges. Now you don't need to ink the edges in the pocket because you can see you're not going to see it. So it's just the three sides. Okay, just check that that fits and that goes in there nicely. So grab your glue . Push that over and push that in. Make sure you've got a nice even border. Even. Okay, get that burnished down. And then the pocket, that was a bit too small, is 2 3/8 by 5 5/8. So 2 3/8. And I'm going to use the back by 5 5/8, just there, I think. Or should I use that? No, I'm going to use that side as well. And you just need to round the bottom left-hand corner. And inky, inky. I'm using Grand Espresso today, but another one for this project would be Vintage Photo. That would be very nice, or Walnut Stain. Even those would equally be nice around the edges. Okay, so let's go and glue that on. So, stick it the right way. Okay, since you've now you've got your base page covered, for our flap, now our flap, because it's near enough the same size as our page, we're going to need to round this corner here. So the way I do it is, where you've scored it, you need to open your score out so that you've got, you've flattened that first half an inch score line. So if you can see there, can you see that? I've flattened that half an inch score line. Okay, so I'm then going to punch my hole round that corner. Okay, so you've got that. So then I'm going to push that score back and then just fold down that second score. So you've got it like that. Okay. And then I'm going to punch again. Okay. That then will create a lovely rounded corner. Okay, so that when we put it onto our page, you get the flow. Okay, next on our list of things to do, with our big flap, we're going to put our double-sided tape along the mountain side fold of our flap. So that would be this bit here. Okay, so we put our double-sided tape along there. Now I'm using a quarter width in school tape, and this school tape is amazing. I have to say it's really good. I use it all the time. It is one of the best in, well, the one of the best that I've ever found in the industry. It's just amazing, it really is. So burnish that school tape down. Like so. Then peel it back. Now we can need to stick it on. Now I'm going to just turn my book the upside down. So that's my pocket. And I'm going to work on the back. So you need to really try and get your flap as central in that page as you possibly can. So you can either have it so that you've got a little tiny gap at the top, or you can have it where you don't see that gap at all. I think I might have it where you can't see any of that paper underneath. I haven't decided. So let's do that. Okay. That will be fine. Okay. So I'm just going to burnish that down. Okay. And we will put a strip across there, so don't worry. Okay. So let me turn my book around the right way, so we can see what we are doing. So that's our flap. Now, next thing we need to do is put our magnet on. Now, I should have done the magnet before I put the pattern paper on, but hey ho, don't worry, we can sort that out. So I'm going to put the magnet basically in the middle. So I'm going to put the magnet underneath, okay, because you want your magnet to have as less in between them as you can, so that you've got more of that magnetic pull. Now, where did I put double-sided? So I'm just going to put one tiny, well, I say tiny, it's quite a big piece now. Okay, double-sided. I'm going to stick that in the middle. Okay. Now, this one here, I'm going to get some of the construction tape and do it so that it is sticky side up and it's facing you. So very gently, if you haven't got this construction tape, I would suggest using removable tape, because this isn't going to stay here, that's going to be taken off. So you get yourself some more scroll tape and one more magnet. Okay, and that's going to go sticky side up. Now we want it so that when you put it on the magnet here, it's repelling it, okay, because when we stick that underneath, that is going to grab it. So you just then need to force that under, well, and it should just find it automatically. Take off this here, take off this magnet here, like so, very carefully so that you don't rip your paper, and just burnish that down. I've got a few sheets of paper in between. I am going to add another magnet on the top here, and then that should just keep that nice and secure. So using the tape, sticky side down this time. Yeah, sticky side down. You could actually put, which I might do, a little spot of glue. And then put the tape over the top. Like that. Okay. And then burnish that down. And then that gives that nice firm stick. Right, so that then is that. We've put the magnet on there like so. So now we can go ahead and cover our flap. So the pattern paper that you'll need for that is 5 7/8 by 5.5. Okay, and you'll need two of those. Okay, right, I'm gonna go with this one, I think. Yes, so round, you only need to round the corner on the top and the two at the bottom. Okay, so work out which one is going to be your front and which is one is going to be on the bottom, or underneath should I say. So again, remember to ink your edges. Looking good, that's looking good. Okay, stick this on. Oh no, now look at that. I'm gonna have to. If I wasn't going to put anything on the top, then I think I would have used that side. Okay, let me turn it over. Guide it into place. Okay, flip it up, and then we can put the bottom one on. Again, remember, get it into position how you want it first of all. So the top two and the bottom left hand corner on this one. So that's that. We just now need to do this, the bottom edge here. Now if I was clever, I would have maybe paper pierced that in, but I have got just a little bit of card left to go on there. So this will be
3/8 by 5 5/8.
There we go. And then just round that edge, if you can, that sort of the corner, if you can. It's going to be a tiny round, but still, if you round it, it will fit in. There we go. Like that. That's looking good. Again, ink your edges. And glue. I'm very quiet today. I think it's because it's a quiet sort of day. There we go, so that goes on there. Okay, having done our flap on the flap now, we need to just round the corners. And I'm going to round all four of these corners on this particular page, but just on the sort of the decorative element, like so. And then that's going to fit under there. So what we need to do is we're going to have an opening on the back. So we need to put our double-sided tape along the outside edges of just the top and the bottom. And if I can find it. Okay. Like so. Near to the edge as you can, because you want to keep that opening as big as possible. Okay, burnish those bits down. Okay, get rid of all those air bubbles. Now, before I stick this bit down, I want to find out where I'm going to put the little flat bit that goes on the bottom. So this bit. So I'm going to put it very central and stick it this way. So, so you need to just line up your flap on flap and your little tiny bottom flap, and you just want it as central as you can between that edge. Ooh. Okay, and put the flap not right directly onto that score line. Leave about a 1/8 of an inch gap between that score line and then where you place this piece of paper. It then will allow that to close. Okay, so that's closed. So let's now, we need to just put another piece of double-sided on that. We can go ahead and stick this bit down. Like so. Burnish that down. There we are. It's going underneath. Like so. Move it that way. You can pull it out that way then. Excellent. And I'll just round these edges. So we now need to put our magnets on. So the magnets are going to go on this tiny piece here, and then the bigger piece, the flap on the flap. Okay. Now you need to work out how you want your flap to be. Do you want it to be like that, so it's closed completely, or let's put that in there. So do you want that to be closed and then this one on the top, or do you want that to be closed and then that one on the top? So you need to work out, because you'll need to obviously gauge where you put your magnets. I think I'm going to go with it outside, but I say the choice is yours. Now, as this is a smaller flat, I'm going to go with the smaller magnets, and these ones are just 10 by 1 millimeters. And again, I'm just going to put one underneath and then one on this side here. So I'm just using the construction tape to keep it adhere it or stick it down. So let's stick it onto the tape, and just as near as you can, or burnish that down so that's nice and secure. Then the next one, we're going to another piece of construction tape, and the sticky side up goes over the top of the magnet that's already in place. Can you see that's the sticky side, because it's shiny? More so than that side, that's sort of not as shiny, but you can see that's the sticky side. Okay, so the sticky side goes sticky side up, makes me think of a sunny side up for eggs, and then the magnet will just naturally find the magnetic force and stick. Okay, so all you need to do now is flap that flap over and then just burnish that all into place, and then that is your magnetic closure done. Now we could put a little tab to open that up if you want to, but I'm going to leave it just for the minute, because I want to put my tags onto my booklet. Again, I'm just going to use the same size magnets. Now, if you didn't want to use magnets on this, you could use one of those poppers. That might that would be an idea as well, if you wanted to use that. As I've got the magnets out, so I'm going to use them. But that just gives you another idea of a closure that you could use. You could also close it with ribbon if you wanted to as well. So there's lots of different ideas. So magnet is just on my sticky tape, and then this one is going to just fit underneath. Now I don't know whether I should maybe put that, I'm going to swap that round, and I'm going to put this underneath. So on that booklet, but on the inside, and then this one is going to go on the other page. So again, sticky side up, let it the magnet find its way. May the force be with you. Okay, and then that's our magnetic closure then for our booklet. So then that can fit into that little secret compartment. I'm going to go with it going this side and open that up, and then that finds that magnet and keeps that nice and closed one way, and then that all just fits nicely in there. And then once we open this up, we've also then got this underneath bit as well. So that gives you lots and lots of different places to put lots and lots of photographs and things. So now we can go ahead and decorate. I tell you what we'll do. We'll leave that for the moment, and we will work on what we're going to do on the inside. Now again, on the inside you've also got this here, so you could put another photo mat on the top there, would look lovely, or you could put some journaling, or a little tuck spot. So there's lots of different scopes, and that's what I like about this size of album. It's not big, it's not huge where you've got lots and lots of space to fill, but it's not tiny where you haven't got enough space to put things in. So let's work on this. So again, let's bring in our trimmer. I thought we could make a little tiny file folder to go in our pocket. You'll need your cardstock, so let me get my cream so you can see what I'm doing. So the cream. So you will need to cut your cardstock at 11 by 5. 11 by 5. Bring in your scoreboard and your score lines with the 11 measurement along the top of your scoreboard, and then you need to score at 2.5 and at 7.5. Okay, fold them over and crease them lines. Like so, and it gives you a little file. So that then opens up and will fit in our little pocket like so. So you could have it where it comes open, or you can have it where it goes in like that, and that closes up. Now you could, if you wanted to, leave this open and not make it into a pocket. It's really up to you, the choice is yours. So I'm going to use the construction tape to seal my two edges of my card. So just put your construction tape over the edge, so it's half on, half off, as Claire Charville says. That's her signature saying, I think. And push that down, and then do the same to the other side. Like so, and then that creates your pocket, okay, in there. So that's like a little filer. So you can round your corners on these ones as well. And if you wanted to do the bottoms, you could. It's really up to you on those, on that effect. So that then is going to fit into our little pocket like that. Okay, for cutting the pattern paper, so our measurements need to be 3 7/8 by 5, and we need 3 of those, and 2 3/8, beg your pardon, and we'll need 2 of those. And then for our little tag book, this needs to measure, so for the pattern paper, 4 3/8 by 4 7/8, and you'll need 4 of those, okay, to fit either on all of the sides. So I'm going to fast forward this, and when we come back, I would have hopefully got all my pieces cut out ready. Right, now all our patterned paper pieces have been cut out for our flap on flap and for our tag booklet. Let's start by gluing them all down. I haven't cut out the pieces yet for the little file folder, but we'll do that next. Right, before you glue down your pattern paper pieces, don't forget to round your corners and ink those edges. Okay, I have finished now sticking all my pieces onto my booklet, and I think it looks really nice. I'm really pleased with how it's turned out, and it can just slide in there. Now we can add some photo mats in there as well if you like, so that we can obviously, or journaling spots, or even a little tuck spot if you wanted to put some smaller pieces in. But I think what we'll do first of all, before we do that, is we'll finish decorating our little file pocket that we've made to go into our pocket. Right, so we need to make our pattern paper needs to be
4 7/8 by 3 1/4.
And then this back piece here, if you don't want to go in all the way inside, make it 3 by 4 7/8. And then this little one here will be 2 3/8 by 4 7/8. And then the back will be 4 7/8, and I think it's a square by 4 7/8. Okay, and then we can make just a tag to go inside there as well. Let's get this stuck down. Now I did actually buy some coal glue, coal, to have a try and see what that's like. So let's have a try. Let's see whether or not it's. I like the smell. I've kind of, not that I'm saying you need to sniff glue. But that tends to be my go-to sense. I tend to try and smell everything. So we're going to put that on like so. Bring that down. Now what I may do, I don't know whether I should put, I think I need to put a, what am I thinking of? A magnet. I need to put a magnet on, I think. So let me get my magnets before I glue anything down. So do we need, no, we're going to go with the smaller magnets and see. They might be a bit better. So get your tape. I'm using the construction tape from My Creative Spirit, but any tape will do. You can even use double-sided. So actually I'm going to stick the bottom one on first, but that needs to go up a bit. So I don't want it where the tape is going to be showing, but I want it where it's going to obviously cover. Right, so sticky side up, the magnet will find its own sticking force. That's okay. I'm just going to turn that over and no, I'm not. I'm going to cut that off like so. And cut it off again. There, that looks very nice. So now I can go ahead and stick it down. I think I may. There we go. And then this here. Stick this one down. So far, so good. This is looking. This glue is not. It's quite good. I'm going to give that quite a big gap there. Okay, that goes on here, goes on the front. So far this koal glue seems to be okay. I haven't got any puckering of the paper, because sometimes you can put glue down, and if it's got high water content in the glue, it can make your papers go all ridgy, and this isn't doing that. This is quite good, and I've got quite a bit of wiggle time as well. So yeah, so far so good. So they go on the back. Were they on the back, or was that in that on there? No, that was the back, wasn't it? So do I need to cut one more? I must need to cut one more out. Okay. So that's going on the front bit. And then this bit was going there. And then I need to cut one more out. I seem to have lost one more. Go, so that's the back. There we go. You've got quite a long time of the wiggle, and I have to get used to that. Actually, it's quite a lot because I can still move that. So let's cut this bit out and just see if I can find something. I don't want to use that. I love that part there on there, so I'm going to make that into a tag. I think that's too small. It might have to be this bit. I think I've got another smallish bit. No, so what did I say? This was 2 3/8 by 4 and 7/8. Let's do the 4 7/8. Actually, let's do 4 7/8 by 2 3/8. Just there. That looks okay. Round the corners at the bottom, and then ink them edges. go, we can get that on there. Put that over. So that's then our little little file folder that can go into our secret flap in there, like so. And because we've got that extra gusset, or that sort of where it can expand, it doesn't look as though the page isn't bowing. So I'm really pleased with that. So we can add our photo mats, whatever photo mats you want to add, we can add them. So I might add one here, and I'm definitely going to add one here, and I'll probably put one on this side. So that's two there. So let's I haven't pre-measured them, so we'll do that live, so to speak. So you'll need some black card, and obviously your white card, whatever you're going to use then for your photo mats. Now I wouldn't use copy paper to make your photo mats up, because it's too thin, but I wouldn't go with a very heavy card. So probably a 160 GSM, maybe a 200, that might be an ideal weight to sort of use, because you don't want it to bulk the album out, but you want it to be sturdy enough so that if you write on it and take it out, it's going to withstand it. So let's pre-measure. I've got my paper, I've got my book.
Right, the photo mats, we're going to make them measure 3¼ by 4¼. This then will give you a space 3x4 for your photographs to go in the photo slots.
So let's put these on here. Now I'm going to round these edges. Oh, I keep saying it. Round my corners. It just rolls off the tongue. Oh. Right, round the edges. Like so. And that one's not rounded very well. There we go. Okay. So, I'm going to go with the... This one is a curved slot. So let's slot these in. One. Make sure when you put in your paper, if you've got these punches, that the corner is really pushed in to the corner of the punch. Otherwise, you'll find that you'll have a wonky corner. So that's our corners done. So the white cardstock, you need to do 1/4 inch smaller. So the white cardstock we're going to do at obviously 4. And I find my white cardstock. So do that at 4 by 3. Bring in our book. OK, Okay, I'm going to round these edges as well, these corners as well. And the, I don't need to do those ones just yet. So let's, fingers crossed that they fit.
You might just need to give them a little bit of a wiggle.
And then they should fit in. And they do, just nicely. Come on. If you've got this punch, then what I would suggest you do is have a look at your photographs that you're going to put into your album and have a look at what size they are, because you might have pictures, your photographs that could be portraits, some could be landscape. So what I would suggest you do is I'm just going to use these as an example. So what I would do is I would go through my album before I did all my photo mats. I would go through and I would have a look. So here I know that these are quite a nice size, these, so I would have a look what photographs I could get on, so we could put some that type of one on there. So then I would measure it and then cut my photo mat to match my photo. So you would have, you could have even like a smaller one, you know, could go down there, and then you could, you know, so that they would fit in. So just have a look at your photographs and what ones you've got, what orientation they are, because as I say, you might have some that are landscape, some that are portrait, you might have some on there that you maybe don't want to have all of the picture in there. So as I say, have a look at what you've got and what you, what photos and things you are going to put in will determine what photo mats you put in. But as I say, I haven't got anything to put in these, so I'm just surmising that this is what I'm going to have in there. So now, yeah, I went off in a tangent there a little bit. So that can go either there and there. So let's, and again, when you put your photo mats in, don't go over the corners because you won't be able to get your photos out, like so. So that's in. Next one. And that goes there. I want it to be virtually in line, like so. Then I'm going to close that up, because that then will help that stick. But we will go in that way, won't we? So then we've got, we come to our little booklet. So again, I'm going to put a photo mat on there, but you could just put a white one and have that all stuck in. So for the photo mats for here, we are going to do some black cardstock. First of all, is going to be 3¼ by 3¼. So you'll need two of those. So let me just do it here. I'll bring that in. So 3¼ by 3¼. And then we two. Okay. And then you want to cut out, that'll be 3×3. So put your corner photo slots in, like so. I'm going to round the corners. Oh, I nearly said it. Round the corners. Okay, and then we can slide this part in. There we go. Like so. Then that can fit there. So you can either have it where they come down like this, although I am going to miss that, cover that word, but never mind. So I'm going to round these corners and then put my photo corners on. and then this should stick or slide through, and it does. And in there, and then that, so you can either have it sort of like that, or you can have them where they are together, right in the middle. I think I'm going to go with them at an opposite sides. So let's put some glue on. I must admit, I like this for quickness, this glue. So far it doesn't seem to be getting clogged up, so that's a plus. I'm hoping that it does stay stuck for a long time. Okay. I did use this when I did my sister's wedding invitations. I did use this on, she had some pearl, it was like a thicker paper, and when I used the Cosmic Shimmer, that did make it buckle a little bit, the paper. So I used this, and that worked brilliantly, I have to say. So that then is that bit done. So open this up. I'm going to carefully slide this in because I don't want that pitch, that photo mat, to move, because it will do, like so. Let's put that over and then shut that up. I have to go that way. There we are. Okay, that might not be sticking because I'd actually done it to go that way, hadn't I?
So to go into our little file folder, in with the Stamperia paper pads, there is usually a sheet with lots of little tags on, which are ideal for putting into your little pockets and things. And they're also great if you want to use them as embellishment toppers as well. They're actually really good for that. So I'm just cutting some up now. I think I'm going to put three in here. And I've just cut the white border, and I've left probably about an eighth of an inch border around them so that they stand out a little bit better. Now, I don't actually slant the corners of these tags. I leave them as rectangles, but there's nothing saying that you can't do that if you want to. So I'm going to put three into my little file folder. I think that's a nice sort of a nice number to put in there. So I'm going to fast forward this a little bit now, and when we come back, we will have backed them onto black cardstock, and then on the back of that I'm going to put a white piece of cardstock so that you can use that as a journaling spot.
There we go. So then that's three little tags that you could even put one on the front of your little file pocket here. You could put that on like that, and then that gives you a actually, let's do that because that looks quite nice on there. So we'll put these three in here, these two in here, like so. So one, make sure that hasn't moved. One, two, and then we'll put that one on the top. I won't put it on with foam pads because actually, yeah, no, I need to keep that on because I don't want too much of the much bulk. Let's just stop this glue again. So we just want it on the top half, really. There we go. You could use double-sided tape, that would work as well, just to stick it on. Maybe I should have used that. But then that gives a nice little look. Now what you could also do is use some glossy accents and put some glossy accents on the dress. That would make it look really nice. I may do that and take some photographs afterwards. But then you can pull that open and that just gives a nice little, another little secret pocket in the secret. So you can go in like so. Don't come up. Does that leak? That fits down. So a last quick look at that page. Because I'm really, really, this page has just come along. I'm just so pleased with this page. So we open this out, and that is like our flip pocket. And then we can pull this out, and that's our little booklet that we can take out. And that you can embellish as much as you want. So you could put, actually, one second. Right, let me just, it might not work, but it might work. Oh, I've got two there. So, these have got little holes in that you can use, you can put brads in, but you could actually use it as just a clip. So, oh, let's put it on, because that looked really good. So, I'm putting on just some cosmic shimmer. If you've got any metal glue like E6000, that might be okay. You only have to be careful because you need to make sure that it's okay for your memory books. So I've just dabbed that all on. So let me push that in through there and then push that down. Okay, now what I may do is I might have to put something heavy on that just to keep that to get that glue to stick. So anyway, so that then we'll put that in and then we can show. So that goes in like so, that goes down, and that closes over the top. That will stick down once that's down there, but that also just looks like a really nice feature at the side here as well. It looks really good. So yes, yeah, so we can open these out, and obviously that comes off, but then we open this pocket up here, and then we've also then got the added bonus of our little file folder that goes in our pocket there. So thank you ever so much for sticking by me this video. This video has been a labour of love. I've absolutely loved doing this video, I really have. It's been really fun. Please subscribe if you're not a subscriber. I'd love you to become one of my subscribers. Helps me carry on making loads of videos like this. I do so enjoy them. I'm also on Facebook and Instagram, and the names will come across the screen. but I'll also put the links in the description down below, as well as some shopping links as well to different things that I've bought. I've also got a brand new group that's just started out called Memories Paper Art. Please come over and join that on Facebook. We're a small group at the minute, but hopefully the more people that join, the more the merrier. So thanks again for this sticking with us on this video. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye. Right, you should have then cut out all your pieces for this page anyway, apart from we've still got to do this one, but we'll work on that in a moment. So starting with this page here, we can go ahead and put on our pieces, but actually before we do that, I'm wondering about having a little tab that you can pull to open it. So I thought what we'll do is I'll try it. Again, this is impromptu. This is off the hoof, as they say. So I haven't planned this, but I thought we could use the Clever Closures by CoolKatz. And they've got one here called a dumbbell one. And I noticed on this paper, you can see there, they've got something very similar on there. So I thought we'd give that a go and maybe use some embossing powder and see whether or not we can recreate that maybe on here. So I'm just going to cut this out of cream card and see what it looks like out of cream. Okay, let's just try it. So it doesn't have to be as near as, but if we can get it a little bit the same, then I suppose it's good. So bring in your embossing bits and bobs. So I need the dab, dab, dab. There we go. I'm going to use this dabber and get a sheet of spare card. And let's just dab this on like so. Oh, I love the smell of this embossing liquid. It's it just smells so nice. Right, I've got Seth up to here, so I've got this one's Crusty Copper or Sea of Tranquility. So let's go with the Crusty Copper. That looks quite nice. I quite like that. I've not tried these yet, so this is as exciting for me as it is for you. Okay, and some tweezers. Right, that possibly would have worked better on black, but it looks really nice over the tabs, like so. I quite like that actually.